Hi dear students, this is Vetrimani Langovan. Today I am going to teach array based implementation of list. In last class we have seen we have two different types of implementations, right? First one is implementation of list using array, implementation of list using a linked list. In this session we are going to see array based implementation. Before going to start this session, I just want to explain again what is array, right? Array is an ordered collection of elements that are stored in a continuous memory location. Array is, see, here is the array. Array always starts from the index 0 and the last element of array is always n, okay? So once again, array is the collection of same type of data stored in a consecutive memory location. Then, what are the basic operations we have? By using list, the operations are insert, delete, find, next, previous, print list, make empty. These are the available operations in list. See, in this video we are going to see only four basic operations: create, insert, delete and display. Now, creation of list using array. So create operation is used to create the list with n number of elements. We all know that n is the boundary limit of array. Array always starts from 0 and ends with array. N, which is nothing but the number of elements present in the array. Okay. So if I want to insert more data that exceeds the array limit, so it will not accept to add the data into the list. So these are the limitation. So if I have the size of 10, means look here I have the size 10. If I want to insert more than 10 data, it's not possible. So that's the limitation, important limitations when comparing with the linked list. Okay, yeah, the declaration of array. Look, I'm defining the size, max size, as 10 unit, and I'm creating the variable for list, which is going to be integer, data type going to be integer, and max size will be 10. N, which is nothing but number of elements. See, by using this routine, create is the function. I'm going to declaring the variable I. See, enter the number of elements to be added in the list, which is number of elements in the list, and then enter the array elements. These are the datas. So we can insert one by one and it's going to be stored in list. Okay, see here, list max size, list I is going to be the number of elements, sorry, the position. Next, insert operation. Insert operation is used to insert an element at particular position, and this also have one principle, we can call it a strategy, something else. Okay, the strategy is inserting an element at any position, it requires pushing the entire array down one position to make room for a new element. So if I want to insert one data in a location, so I have to move all the data from that position one step ahead. Okay, otherwise it will replace the current data. So that's the important principle when I'm trying to insert the data. So you can see the notation here, integer I, data which I'm going to insert, pys, which is nothing but it's a position. So I am asking enter the data to be inserted. After inserting the data, I am asking enter the position at which the element is going to be inserted. So here I am asking on which position if we want to insert. Then if the position is equal to n, see array overflow. I already told you the limitation. If the size, maximum size, is exceeded, I can't enter a new data into the array. Okay, so if the condition fails, see, I can go for this loop. I can insert. Look, I already told you I have to move the element one step ahead. List I plus 1 equal to list of I. So I hope you understood the logic. If the data which is I am going to insert is on position I, okay, so from ith position I am moving the data to I plus 1 position, and then list POS minus 1. So that is the current position which I am going to enter. See, POS, so equal to data, then I am incrementing the total size. The current size is equal to n is equal to n plus 1 because I have added one data now, right? So previously the size will be n, now I have added one more data, so n size will become additional one additional field. Okay, now the next operation is going to be deletion. So deletion is the process of removing an element from array at any position. So deleting an element in the end is very easy, right? Otherwise, deleting at position requires shifting all the elements in the list one position up. That is reverse strategy of insertion. So in insertion, we have to move next, right? That is move down, position down. So here we are going to up the position. So from the routine, you can see, I am asking enter the position of data to be deleted, and then enter the data, see, which is just calling here. See, list of I is equal to list of I plus 1. In previous rotation, we can see list of I plus 1 is equal to list of I. But here, I am moving list of I data, sorry, list of I plus 1 data into ith position. Okay, so that's the difference between insert and delete. And then I am reducing the number of elements by n is equal to n minus 1. And next, the final one, display. So display is the process of travel all the elements in the array. So which is nothing but traversal is the process of visiting all the elements in the array. It is used to display all the elements present in the array. Okay, look here, by using display function, simple strategies are there. So the elements in the array, I'm using the for loop from starting node and in starting position 0 and ending position n, and I'm incrementing the positions. Printf %d calls the integers, and it's from list. Okay, so we'll get the output as the entire list. Thank you. So here I have given the simple explanations for array based implementation of list, and if you have any doubts, you can ask in comments or you can mail to wingslecture@gmail.com. thank you, dear students. We can see in next video.